Hey everybody, it's Jeff here once again with our Community Works program, talking with our local nonprofit folks, people that are doing just cool things in the community, and really trying to raise awareness for some organizations that you may or may not even know about. So today we're going to talk about Equine Rehabilitation Center of Central Texas.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And this is Lisa.
Yes. Hi. Thanks
so for having me. She is the executive director, founder extraordinaire of Equine Rehabilitation, and talk a little bit about what they do. And it's very interesting, especially if you're into horses. It really serves two unique purposes in the community. So why don't you tell us a little bit about how you got started and why you got started?
Well, I have a love for horses.
Okay.
And my daughter got me into it, I'm afraid. She's the hunter jumper. And so when she went off to school and lost interest, I started buying my own horses. And and I found that I really love to rescue horses and rehabilitate them. It's just very satisfying to see a sick, you know, downtrodden horse blossom and turn into a very healthy and lovely horse. So I did that as a volunteer for a number of years.
Okay.
And then moved up to Leander and decided that maybe I should start a nonprofit so I can do some fundraising.
Okay.
And so I did. I founded Equine Rehabilitation Central Texas.
Mm-hmm.
We say ERCT, a little shorter.
Yeah.
That was in 2012.
Okay.
And then I got 501c3 status January of 2013.
All right.
So I did that for a couple of years, rescued and rehabbed horses, and a lot of skinny horses coming in and you know, healthy horses going out, and it was just wonderful. But it's very, very expensive to rehab
They're
horses.
They're
an eating machine, and they always require a lot of veterinary care, farrier care, and supplements. And you know, I'd buy the best for them, the best hay, best feed, best supplements. So in 2014, I started as a program of ERCT, Hopeful Hearts Therapeutic Riding. And that is a path-centered therapeutic riding center that provides equine therapy or therapeutic riding for people with disabilities.
Okay.
So I started that in 2014, and at this point we do about 80 lessons a week. And so it's building and building, and there's a high need out there for this type of service, and it's becoming pretty popular. So we just keep getting more and more referrals, and we love it. I love it. I'm living the dream.
Sure. And then the horses, you know, they feel that they're kind of involved in the process too. They get to interact with humans.
And exactly. And so for those rescued horses that are rehabilitated, we then evaluate them to see if they have the right temperament to stay with the therapeutic riding program to be a safe, reliable horse. Sometimes they are, and sometimes they're not.
Sure.
And when they're not, then I find a good home for them after training and working with them for a while.
Okay.
And if they are, they stay. And so one of our recent rescued horses from the Arkansas-Louisiana kill pen is named Jonah, and he's a big Belgian.
I've seen pictures of him.
Oh, he is
massive.
The sweetest, big, huge horse, and we just adore him, and he loves people. And I can tell that he really loves his job.
Yeah.
When he's carrying people around or children around, you know, he just looks like he's
in heaven. This is what I was meant to do.
I was meant to do, and I really think there's something in these horses that they appreciate. They recognize that they're much happier and they're healthy now. So not all of our horses are rescued horses though, because like I say, they don't all have the right temperament. But we have 9 lovely horses, all different breeds and sizes and colors. They're all sweet and have been evaluated to be safe riding horses. But they're still horses, so we do teach safety. So our children and adults that come for the therapeutic riding learn safety first, and then how to groom and how to saddle. And they get on and ride, and we serve everyone from children with autism to, you know, adults with cerebral palsy to youth with mental health disabilities.
And you do some work with veterans too, right?
With veterans also, yes. We have a veteran program going on right now, funded by the Texas Stars Foundation.
Nice.
So we hope to continue that. But yeah, I really enjoy the veterans. We The veterans come out on Friday, so mm-hmm. after I leave here, I'm heading straight
and
over
straight
there.
Straight over there to have fun with the guys.
Have fun with the guys and the girls, too. There's some girl veterans. So, yeah, they love it. Mm-hmm. Everybody says they feel peace
yep.
when they get off the horse, and they feel grounded, and everyone says it's such a peaceful environment that sometimes they don't even ride. They just come on out and mm-hmm. hang out.
Sure.
You know, and that's fine with me. We love it, and
that's
I have
awesome.
A full staff now. Thank
now,
goodness.
is there any cost for the program for the people that come to it? Or
well, we do have private pay for that.
Okay.
But then we also have funding sources, mm-hmm. different Medicaid waiver programs fund it, and different county programs also fund it. Mm-hmm. We work with those funding sources and the families, you know, individually also.
Yeah, and make it work for them.
Make it work for them, exactly. Okay. We have a nice event coming up.
So what's this one? Yes, do you
this
you,
is
you
our
brought
Halloween,
this?
Our Halloween bash, October
nice.
27th, and we're going to be doing this every year. And it's just a fun event
okay.
because we have a trail going through the woods.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a haunted trail.
Nice.
And so we're going to be doing rides through the haunted trail mm-hmm. all evening. And we're going to take a break from the rides to have a professional natural horsemanship demo by
oh,
Carrie
cool.
April,
okay.
who's a four-star Pirelli professional.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to have instructor and horse a costume contest. So all the horses are dressed in costume.
Okay.
It's hilarious.
Yeah.
And all the instructors will be in fully decked out in costume, and we'll be doing the hot costume contest and apple bobbing contest with mm-hmm. the horses.
And they're going to win.
Yeah. It's just silent auction, all kinds of carnival games, and boy, can we use a lot of help to
okay.
put this on.
That's fantastic.
So please, if anybody sees this and would like to come help, it's going to be a blast, and it's going to be a lot of hard work too.
So do you use, and I meant to ask this when you were talking about the therapy techniques and all that, so is this something that you had developed proprietary, or do you use a method of training?
Good question. No, it's all PATH centered.
Okay.
PATH is Professional Association of Therapeutic Horsemanship.
Okay, great.
And so there's three of us instructors that are certified.
They're certified with PATH.
And we are PATH member center.
Mm-hmm.
We have two more instructors that are PATH instructors in training.
Mm.
And so they're working through a mentorship program with us.
Okay.
And we hope that they'll be certified this year.
So that's what allows you then to get the
yes.
funding from Medicare
yes.
and all
yes.
that it is
exactly.
a recognized program. It's
exactly.
not just you doing whatever you want to do.
Yes.
Okay.
And so it's
wonderful.
A pretty stringent program
mm-hmm.
to go through. I mean, it's quite demanding. You know, you have to be a very good rider, and
mm-hmm.
you have to be a very good instructor, and you have to know all about horses and disabilities
mm-hmm.
and know how to keep everybody safe.
Yeah.
So,
how long does that take typically to get through that program?
You know, typically about a year.
Okay.
Sometimes it takes people a couple of years.
Mm-hmm. Just depends.
It yeah. depends on how quickly you work through the program.
Yeah. Well, and so. Your ability just to do it. I mean,
exactly.
not everybody's doing this as a living.
Yes.
But they can help and work in the organization if they're
right.
trying to go towards that direction.
Exactly. Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me a little bit about some of the challenges that you have running this organization.
Well, it's always expense, you know, and
yep.
that's really the big issue with horses, because
mm-hmm.
unlike a therapist that has an office, a professional office, or
sure.
physical therapist, occupational therapist, I mean, they have their expenses too, but with horses, not only do you need the land,
mm-hmm.
but it's about $550 every month for every horse.
Ooh.
And so we have 9 horses.
Mm-hmm.
And 2 little miniature donkeys, can't forget them.
Okay.
And then a full staff. It's a very expensive
sure.
business to operate. You know, we've made it work though, and
mm-hmm.
it's successful.
And you've grown every year.
We've grown every year,
yep.
exactly. And it's just a lot of fun.
Yeah, absolutely. So what are some of the ways that folks out there can actually help the organization? What are some things that they can do to help you?
They can contact me, they can go to our website,
okay.
and I can see what it is they're interested in doing.
Mm-hmm.
We do a new volunteer orientation every month.
Okay.
So newcomers can come in and be oriented to the business and the program, and see if they'd like to get involved. We need a lot of help being sidewalkers and horse handlers.
Okay.
And we just need a lot of help taking care of the horses
mm-hmm.
and taking care of the property. We do projects like painting and building and repairing. And so if you don't really want to be a sidewalker or a mm. horse handler, there's always something.
But if you want to chip in, if you've got
chip in any
if you've
way,
got carpentry skills or something,
yes,
I'm sure it's
bring them on. Right now, I need someone that can drive a tractor. You know,
yeah.
Know anybody that can drive a tractor?
I'm sure we could learn if we had to.
Okay. Yeah.
But, all right. So if you're out there and you know how to drive a tractor, bingo! There's a great skill you can bring to the table.
Yep.
Beyond this event that's coming up, what other things are coming up? Going into next year even?
Well, we are doing an end of year fundraising campaign.
Okay.
Just to bring money in, and the emphasis this year is to help us pay for our horses.
Yeah.
Because they're so expensive. But we also have so many things. We need to build more shelter for the horses with winter coming up.
Yeah.
We've grown in the number of horses we have, so we need more shelters.
Okay.
We also need, you know, golly, anything that you want to donate for the horses. Goodness, there's unlimited projects.
There you go.
Yes.
So for the construction companies that I know are listening to this, here's a great project for you and your teams to come out and help out and build, you know, some simple structures for the horses and all that. So
yes.
I challenge you to pull this together and come out and reach out and help.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for doing what you do. Of course, however we can help, we want to, and we really appreciate you being part of our community here. Where are you located at, by the way, so people can find you?
Our address is in Leander, but we're actually closer into Cedar Park.
Yep.
We're just right off of 1431, heading towards Jonestown, but it's before Jonestown, and you would
and
just turn off.
It's right after the New Hope.
Right road, after New Hope, you turn left on Trails End Road, left on Trails End Cove, and there we are.
Beautiful. On the left-hand side.
That's right.
Okay. Well, folks, if you can help out, or if horses are your thing, or if you are not sure if they're your thing, but you want to go out there and try, this is a wonderful opportunity to, if you can't afford to have a horse, you can have your own stable of horses to hang out with every week.
That's right.
Please feel free to reach out to her.
The website address is www.horseserct.org.
Okay.
And all of our contact information is there. I'm Lisa Rivers, but feel free to call me on my cell phone anytime and email me. I'll get right back with you.
Awesome. So we will have that information in our show notes page. So right down below me, right by the subscription button, and if you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you click on the subscription button because you'll miss these things if you don't. If you're viewing this on our website, just same thing. In the show notes page is going to have this information and how to contact Lisa and their organization. I challenge all of you, if this is something that you are interested in, or if you want to spend a great Halloween with a bunch of dressed up horses.
It's going to be a blast. You're going to
laugh. This is a perfect opportunity. I just can't wait to see what Jonah's dressed in.
Oh, yeah. He's going to be the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah, that makes complete sense.
Yes.
That said, folks, thank you so much for once again tuning in. We look forward to seeing you back here next week. So thanks and have a great day.
Yeah.